All right, everyone. Welcome to the end times. Cheers. It's easy to dwell on the problems, difficult to dwell on the remedies. So what we need to do is dwell more on the remedies, which I've been trying to do. I've always known from before birth what's going to happen here in this world. There's no question about it. But I don't really like to dwell on that. There's no answers there. So we have to dwell on the answers. What are the answers? Well, how can we wrap our mind around, as it were, the answer? How can we make it comfortable, acceptable? Come on in, sit down, you know, make yourself at home. So how do we condense it down? That's always the challenge. All day long I'm taping on MP3 recorders and trying to condense it down, simplify. It's very simple. We are attempting to be the authors of our own salvation. That is the problem. Our problem is the continuity issue. Period. There is no other problem that we have. None. And yet, how we address the continuity problem is crucial. So we have one problem and one thing works, another thing doesn't. So we need to resolve the problem. You might say resolving the continuity issue should be our only focus. That is it. When we try to be the authors of our own salvation, in other words, we try to resolve the continuity issue, that is the big mistake. And when we allow the Holy Spirit to resolve the continuity issue for us, that's salvation. It's really simple. But what I've found is the simplicity tends to evaporate when you're out in the world around people, because there's just a complete vacuum, as it were, of unawareness of this. And that just, wow, it just puts it out of focus. Even for me, it gets out of focus. I say, my God, that's amazing. How's that possible? I'm so focused on it, and yet just moving around the world and people, it gets out of focus. Because everybody's trying to be the author of their salvation. Humanity is trying to save itself. It's impossible. Totally impossible. And I can explain exactly why it's totally impossible. So all of this can be explained, but it will all get out of focus for you as soon as you go about your daily business. That is the trouble, really. So bringing it back in focus is a constant problem. And yet we have to do that. So I get up in the morning. What's the problem? The continuity issue is the only problem we have. How does it get resolved is the question. Now, when we try to be the authors of our own salvation, what we are doing is playing God, plain and simple, which is the whole problem we're in anyway, is we want to be God. We want to be prime creator. We want to replace the prime creator. So of course we're not going to accept the prime creator resolving the continuity issue for us, because that would prove that we're not prime creators. We need help. No, we say, no, we don't need any help. We can solve this problem. And thus we just spin our wheels like in the sand. Just spin our wheels. We're not solving it at all. It's we have not gone anywhere whatsoever in solving the continuity problem, actually. Now, let's just take humanity, the history of humanity. Throw it out. You know, it's start over, so to speak. We haven't gotten anywhere. We've just spent time trying to be the authors of our own salvation, which is complete futility. Now, there have been some teachings that say, no, the Holy Spirit is the author of your salvation, that God created the Holy Spirit specifically to resolve the continuity issue for us. That is a fact. That is the truth. But where do you see that emphasis? I can't find that emphasis anywhere. Anywhere. You go out in the world and you lose that focus like that. If this is your focus that I have, evaporate. Out of focus. Severely out of focus. And therefore, that just shows we are desperately trying to solve our own problems. And again, the only problem we have is the continuity problem. That is the only problem we have. If we didn't have that problem, we would drop existence immediately. right this instant, we would drop it and never even think about it ever again, like it never happened. Everyone would do that if it weren't for the continuity problem. Guaranteed. So the continuity problem is what keeps this craziness going, period. Period. Nothing else. And it's totally leveraged, completely leveraged. It's a dualistic leverage. The defense systems that we have to hold on to existence are so leveraged. It's nothing but leverage. And so you cannot figure it out intellectually or mentally really at all. We desperately need the Holy Spirit to resolve it for us. And what we do, we need to just give everything over to the Holy Spirit. Everything we've ever done, decided, thought, all our decisions, everything that's ever constituted involvement in perception and form, etc., and just hand it over and say, okay, here, you resolve this, because you're the expert, you're created perfectly and flawlessly to do this, and just, you know, it's called surrender, but it's really just, you know, running it through the filter. Say, here, filter this, filter everything that I've ever, you know, that ever we call me or whatever, filter it all, all my perceptions, all thoughts, decisions, activities, choices, you name it. Ultimately, that's the goal. And when we can do that without any exception, then the Holy Spirit can work miracles like that for us, amazing miracles for us, collapse time for us, and just order our lives, you know, flawlessly in the right way to resolve the continuity issue for us. But if we hold something out, something apart, the leverage of the ego defense systems, just leverage, no matter what you hold out, it can be leveraged into an entire defense system, actually. That's the problem we have, is leverage. The mind is infinitely creative, and so it can take any little bit and leverage it into a complete, massive defense system of delay. Absolutely can. So we can't make any exceptions. We have to be willing to give everything to the Holy Spirit, because then it will filter it and leave nothing but exactly what is required to resolve the continuity issue in our case. For sure it will. Again, that's a focus that you don't see in the world. Everybody's out of focus, as it were, very badly out of focus, and trying to bring it into focus. You can get it in focus, and then poof, the world knocks it out of focus again. It's like a delicate instrument. Someone bumps it, keeps bumping it, and says, whoa, it's out of focus again. You say, doggone it, I've just had it in focus so many times, and it gets out of focus. So the situation is simple, and the simpler we see it, the better off we are. Oh, okay, just turn everything over to the Holy Spirit. Say, here, you do the judging of everything, because its only judgment is to solve the continuity issue. That is it. It has no other purpose. Holy Spirit only resolves the continuity issue for us. And the continuity issue means to go from dreams of how we die, kill ourselves, existence is spirit trying to kill itself, actually, so it can then die to what it is and become something greater, which is prime creator. So all these dreams of death that we've been dreaming, the difference between them and reality is so, there's no commonality whatsoever, none, no commonality. So how do we go from one situation, total immersion in one situation, the total immersion in another, where there's zero commonality between the two? That is the continuity problem. And it's here, everyone has it, and it won't go away by itself. And it will only go away through, the Holy Spirit knows how to resolve it for us. We don't know how to resolve it. We cannot, it's impossible. And yet we keep trying, because we want to prove, no, we're prime creator, we're God, therefore we can resolve any problem, including the continuity problem. Pride is the problem. I mean, it just, so you just see this, and you see it and say, okay, I see this. It doesn't resolve the continuity problem, but it gets us closer to turning it over to the Holy Spirit, the whole mess, and say, okay, here's the mess. Here's this big mess, and you deal with the mess. You're perfectly created to deal with this, so you deal with it. I'm not going to try and keep dealing with it. It's up to you. And you know, we keep trying to get to that point, and some have got to that point, and they've said it's just a miracle that their lives just everything all unhappiness, misery, everything just gone forever, and it's just really an incredible miracle. But it's God created the Holy Spirit to resolve the continuity problem. Period. That's it. So this focus is right on the money, but easy to lose focus on this. And that's the problem. So what people do is they think, well, let's find something that it's not easy to lose focus on, and go with that. It seems to make more progress that way. Problem is, you end up focusing on something that doesn't work, which doesn't get you anywhere. So very tough situation, really. Now, the parting of the ways that we've talked about is simply those who want to continue to try and be authors of their own salvation will go one direction, and those who decide to turn it over to the Holy Spirit and let the Holy Spirit resolve the continuity issue will go in a different direction, of course. Entirely different situation. So that's what's happening right now. There's been a huge, huge push by the ego recently to get all of us on board with being the authors of our own salvation. And the entire educational system of this planet is on board with that, from head to toe. The entire culture, the entire media, the entire, almost everything on this planet is on board with that, trying to be authors of our own salvation, teaching, learning, getting smarter, all this stuff. Absolute folly, total ignorance. What Buddha would say, the root of suffering is ignorance. In other words, you're ignorant of the facts, and you can be very smart and learn it, etc., trying to be the author of your own salvation, and yet it's complete folly. And the spiritual path the work you do to gradually be able to accept this fact that trying to be the author of your own salvation is folly. And of course, most people who take the spiritual path have tried to be authors of their own salvation, and therefore they're very smart, oftentimes very, very smart, very learned, or they have a lot of experience, and they know just it doesn't work. It hasn't worked. Why? And so it's very difficult to accept that we cannot do it, because that proves we're not prime grader, doesn't it? So it's a disillusioning process. I mean, last night I had a very rough time. I was really very badly hurting last night because the Holy Spirit told me, hey, you know, the situation here is going to get so terrible, you need to leave. And it was a blow to your pride. You think, oh, no. I said, I know the truth. I can help out. And the Holy Spirit says, no, you don't realize how bad it's going to get. And I say, well, you're right, but I was really hurt, about that. But as I said previously in videos, back of 1999 or 98, somewhere around there, the Holy Spirit told me, you have to stop watching television, period. Just stop. No more. And I said, no, I understand what it's about, what it's trying to do. I want to monitor it. I'm curious how bad it's going to get, and I can avoid the problems. And the Holy Spirit said, no, you don't realize how bad it's going to get. You don't realize it. So you've got to stop, otherwise you're going to fail. You're going to not succeed in turning over the continuity issue to me. So I said, okay, you're the boss, and stopped cold turkey, and I've never gone back to it. Other than just occasional sporting event, but other than that, no way. And now looking at it, I see, oh, the Holy Spirit was right. My God, it's become so terrible. In just the few instants that I see it, it happens to be on someplace. I look at it, I just say, oh my God, how can anyone watch that? It's just so terrible. It is the church of the Antichrist. It is constantly pouring out every kind of deceitful mechanism to convince you need to be the author of your own salvation. Humanity is the author of its own salvation. Total lies. It is hideous. So when the Holy Spirit says, look, the situation is going to be worse than you realize, it's good to listen to that. It's very important to listen to that. So it's been saying to me for a long time, look, the world situation is going to get worse than you realize. And most of these videos are pointing this out. You know, yeah, it's bad, but it's going to be way worse than we know. And we're starting to feel that, right? It's like we've seen the tip of the iceberg, and then we're starting to look under the surface of the ocean, and we say, oh my gosh, it feels like there's a massive amount underneath the ocean. The tip, you know, the tip of the iceberg is bad enough, but it must be huge under there. And it's true. So we're just starting to cut our teeth now on what's coming. And again, curiosity killed the cat. Curiosity killed the cat. Don't be curious about it. And I had somebody actually ask me something. Say, I'm curious. Curiosity killed the cat. Can you tell me something? And she kept repeating it. And I said, wow, that's something I'm supposed to pay attention to. Curiosity killed the cat. In other words, if you're curious about how bad it will get and you want to just see, then that's really, you're going to perish with that. It doesn't matter how bad it gets, because the facts are still the same. The Holy Spirit is the only one that can solve the continuity issue and has no problem with it whatsoever, none. We can't solve it, so it doesn't matter how bad it is or not bad it is. We don't have to measure it. The Holy Spirit doesn't require our measurements of how bad it is. It doesn't require it. Not necessary. We don't have to monitor anything, really. And this is great freedom, and some have realized this, you know, fortunate ones for sure, fortunate ones. And I always wonder, how in the world did they get to that point? I don't know. Each path is a custom path, so there's no way we can judge our path with someone else's path. Very, very custom, because of all the leveraging, constant leveraging is done. It's like everyone is different in the leverage situation that they have. It's like everyone's going down that certain direction, but they're all walking different. Their gait is different. So the Holy Spirit uses leverage in each case, you know, differently according to what the defense of leverage is. So you cannot really figure out from anyone else how to do it. You cannot. You can waste your time. It really wastes your time. It's best to just continue on with your own relationship with clarity of the Holy Spirit, the voice of reason, voice of clarity, and the orchestrator of the resolution of the continuity problem. Just continue on with that, but you don't try to figure out, you know, where do I stand and compared to someone else, or I'm not doing what they're doing, or all this stuff. It's a waste of time. So we can feel this like pyramid effect, right? The whole situation, the iceberg or pyramid effect, you see the top and then the base, you know, we can feel it, say, oh my gosh, this is just exponentially, we're being asked to be dumb, stupid, really stupid. The pressure is on to be stupid, there's no question about it. It's just shocking, stunning. I mean, even though I know it's coming, it's still stunning. There's no way around it. And we can't afford to be too stunned, actually, by it. Really, the Holy Spirit says you got to get out of it, and you're not, the remedy is to get out of it. You know, when you have a situation where there's too much pressure to stupefy, you know, to dumb you down, too much pressure, too much reinforcement, if you don't get out of that situation, you are going to succumb to it. So the question is, how do we get out of it? And I always ask the Holy Spirit that, and hasn't answered directly yet. So just continue clarification. And the theme is relocation. There's no question about it. How do you get out of it? You know, if you're in it, you need to go somewhere, get out of it somehow. But preparation is necessary, and each one is preparing slightly differently. So, I do get answers, quote unquote, you go to Hawaii, quote unquote. Well, Hawaii just means like idyllic place, is what it means. Take a vacation to Hawaii, in other words. Take a vacation to an idyllic place, but where on this planet is there an idyllic place? And of course, it's like a slap in the face because you think, I should be able to help, I should, but the Holy Spirit is the one that solves the continuity problem, not us. So if it says, this is what you need to do so that I can resolve the continuity issue for you, that's what we have to do. We have to swallow our pride and be humble about the situation. We cannot solve the continuity problem for anyone else. Nobody can whatsoever. Impossible. We only make things worse when we try. What we should be doing as a culture and community and world, etc., is to greet one another and say, I accept the fact you can't solve a continuity problem for me, you know. Like, I accept the fact that you cannot. I'm not asking you to solve a continuity problem for me. And each one should come in that greeting. I accept that I cannot solve your problem and you cannot solve mine. What a sigh of relief that would be, wouldn't it? That we can't solve each other's problems. It's impossible. That's a truly advanced society. And then there wouldn't be all this drama and all this stuff. Oh, no drama. Why? You know, you cannot solve my problem. I cannot solve your problem. Together, we cannot solve our problems. Impossible. Only the Holy Spirit can solve the problem. For anyone, for us, for anyone. And there's nothing we can do to solve the problem. It's impossible. So we take this burden of expectations off our shoulders, off our own shoulders, that we realize we can't help others, and then off the shoulders of others can't help us. We accept that. We don't get angry at them, you know, that they're not helping us enough, etc., etc. What happens in this world is everyone keeps reinforcing, hey, we can do it. Together, we can do it. If we just, you know, maybe if we just sing a song and drink some Coca-Cola together and have a smile, have a Coke and a smile, we'll teach the world to sing a perfect harmony, won't we? I'd like to teach the world to sing in perfect harmony, right? Yeah, that is the average, that is the world. The world says, hey, look, why don't we all just have a Coke and a smile and hold hands and sing in perfect harmony and we can do it. We can do it. That is the overriding vibe of this planet, where, of course, religion says, no, you cannot do it. You cannot do it. You cannot be the author of your own salvation. That is the key message of religion. Should be. But it's degenerated in various ways as this pressure to push it under, that all these agendas to destroy this message on this planet right now are very strong, very, very strong. Many, 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 many angles, like an avalanche is happening to submerge this, the true message of religion. We cannot be the authors of our own salvation. And to attempt to is to miss the mark, is to sin, is to fail. Is to fail, continued failure. It doesn't matter if everybody on the planet holds hands, has a Coke and a smile and sings together, that's not going to do anything. It won't do anything. People get together and, you know, sing songs, prayers, it doesn't do anything. The clarity has to be there, or else you're just making things worse, actually. People get together, they should say, we accept that we cannot solve the continuity issue. We accept that no matter how much we congregate and pray, we cannot solve a continuity issue. We accept that we cannot solve it for anyone else. We cannot solve it for ourselves. We cannot solve it for anyone else. There is nothing we can do to solve the continuity problem except turn it over to the Holy Spirit, period. Right? And we accept that this is a fact, this is true, and the Prime Creator has created the Holy Spirit specifically to resolve. And we thank the Prime Creator for doing so. This needs to be the focus. If that's not the focus, doing more harm than good. But really, that's why I say junk the whole thing. Junk the whole thing. We're not doing each other any favors in this world. Start over. And with a very simple focus. Very simple focus. Again, if any prayer said we admit that we're helpless to solve this problem that we have, the continuity problem. And everyone, no one, none of my brothers and sisters can solve it. No one can. Together, we cannot solve it. Together, we cannot solve it apart. It's insolvable for us, except through the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit can resolve it perfectly for everyone. Perfectly. No problem whatsoever for the Holy Spirit. No inconvenience, no problem. It's custom designed to do exactly that. And so we do have our Comforter. It's not you. It's not me. No, we're not supposed to comfort one another. It's the Holy Spirit that's the Comforter. We are supposed to acknowledge our incapacity and not berate each other for this. Not say, hey, you're not studying enough. You know, I need you to study more. You're not being successful enough. You're not doing enough. I want you to do for me. Help me out. Help me out. Help. No. That's all backwards. So we've got it completely backwards in this world. So backwards that, you know, it's just now becoming institutionalized, this backwardsness. The course religion had at the root, it said, well, we're all sinners. We acknowledge our sin. You know, there's a just a trace of it. There's a trace of it. Used to be more, but now there's just a kind of a faint trace of it still there, like a faint odor, you know, as it were, like, what is that? Faint echo. I hear something faintly echoing, and maybe at some point it was a beautiful sound, but I just can hardly, it's very elusive now, I can hardly hear it. That's the situation we're in right now. And so there's a huge effort to institutionalize the lie that we can be the authors of our own salvation. That is the lie. That is the central lie. And there, no stone is being left unturned to institutionalize that on this planet now, forever, and to completely wipe out any other message, the opposite message, the truth, that the Holy Spirit is the author of our salvation, which really means God is, because God created the Holy Spirit for this purpose. The effort is to wipe that out as if it never was, and just to, you know, rewrite history like it never happened here. It never happened here. And of course they're going to remodel the planet. That's going to happen. I've seen the remodeled planet. I was taken through time in the future and walked upon the remodeled planet. And you cannot cannot recognize it as this planet at all. And there's no history. There's nothing there as far as history goes. So from their standpoint, none of this ever happened. Religion never happened. The effort to realize the truth and accept that we cannot be the authors of our own salvation never happened. Poof, gone. So, that's the goal. That is really the goal. When we talk about, and people are very uncomfortable with this goal, which is why there's resistance to all this stuff that's going on in the world. People say, now wait a minute, wait. Let's not throw the baby out with the bathwater here. I feel like, you know, you're trying to pull a fast one on me. And indeed, that is true. It's by hook or by crook, they are trying to extirpate this message of salvation, the true message of salvation. It's not enough to just distort it. They want to make sure it never arises ever again. Because it's an affront to their arrogance. It's an affront to their belief that they can become prime creator. And they should be able to solve any and all problems to prove this fact, you know. And how dare anyone say that there's a problem they can't solve? You know, it's an utter affront to their dignity, their self-esteem, all this kind of nonsense. So it will be, you know, criminalized. As the Holy Spirit said, it'll get worse than you can imagine here. And you can tell the storm is coming. You can feel the wind shifting and say, wow, there's some huge hurricane out there, you know, huge hurricane out there. And the Holy Spirit says it's worse than you can possibly know. So don't hang around trying to be curious about it. You know, get out of harm's way. That's a wasp. Huh. Wow. Okay. Up by the light. Maybe it's enjoying the light. I don't know. Wow. Yeah. Okay, so go to an idyllic place it's easy. I mean, what to say, the attitude is easy. I just presented it here. You work on acknowledging that we cannot solve this continuity problem, but the Holy Spirit can. And you go towards that goal of turning over your entire junkyard that you have to the Holy Spirit. We have this huge junkyard, everyone, of all our efforts to solve this continuity problem. Huge junkyard. And you just say, here, Holy Spirit, you know, I can't solve it anyway, so this stuff, this junk is useless to me. So you, here, you do whatever you want to with it. You know what? We'll get something back incredibly beautiful, miraculously beautiful. We will not even be able to, you know, understand how's that possible. Wow, it's incredible. The Holy Spirit is a complete genius. Created, of course, created by God specifically to deal with this continuity issue that we have. And it's God's responsibility because God created us and created mind, created spirit, and the adventurousness of spirit, and spirit chose the idea of wanting to be prime creator, what brought about this effort to accomplish this simply by overlearning, by waiting, delaying, overlearning, and just trying to get used to all these forms dying. It's a symbolization of death. Simply try to make a lie true by just waiting forever, as it were. So of course we overlearn it all. Of course we're enmeshed in this and we're so used to it. It has no commonality with reality whatsoever. So of course there's this gigantic continuity issue that we have. And God knows that. God says, yeah, that's my problem. I mean, that's for me to deal with, okay? Because I didn't create you to deal with this, but I did now create the Holy Spirit to deal with this, and so these are the simple facts. And yet when you stop this video and you go about your business, you will forget this like you never watched it. That's the problem. There's no reinforcement for this. You just try talking like this to any person in the world and they'll just tune you out and just say, whoa, I don't know, you know, I'm losing my focus. They'll say, well, wait a minute, I'm losing my focus. So they got their idea. They got themselves focused on how can I be the author of my salvation? How can we, humanity, save itself? You know, that's their focus. And so you tell them the truth and they start to say, oh my God, I'm losing my focus. You know, what do I do? It scares them. They feel that they're losing their focus on salvation, except they don't realize they're losing their focus on damnation and turning it towards salvation. But they don't see it that way. So, some of these perceptual, visual type of videos that I'm doing is to stretch your imagination, your perception, your expectations to an idyllic place. Something that is just like, whoa, it is just so incredibly beautiful. You just sit there and just, oh my gosh, you just want to sit there in silence, you know. It's just the sounds of the place, the vibe of the place is so incredible. The lushness, the beauty, the peace, the serenity, the calm, the vibe is just amazing. No need for maintenance. No need for maintenance. Just let everything be. It's just natural. We don't have estates with all these flowers planted. We're not busy, you know, tilling our gardens. We're simply letting everything just be the way it is. Beauty, incredible beauty. So, I'm trying to produce these very abstract or very beautiful perceptual videos to prepare us for that. Because the whole thing, the promise of quote-unquote the rapture, the exodus, the ascension, all that stuff, it's all true. It's all true. The catastrophes coming to planet, it's all true. It's all true. And so we just prepare for it. But it's been distorted. We don't quite have it in focus, you know. We don't have it in focus. So it will come into focus when the time is there. You know, it will come into focus. But in the meantime, we keep our clarification going. We keep expanding our perceptual boundaries. Keep expanding our expectations for to dwell in a very, very sacredly beautiful place where we just can just sit anywhere. We can literally just sit anywhere and just like, wow, you know, the atmosphere, everything there is just putting on this incredibly beautiful show for us. Yeah, it's just, it's very elevating for sure. And then it's like a vacation. And then at some point, we may check back in with this world, or how it's going to go, I don't know. But I'm sure it will be, you know, flawlessly handled. But we want, the purpose of it is to avoid the dumbing down phase right now. Once the conflict gets bad, etc., we might be able to help at some point. But if we're dumbed down at this point, we won't be able to help later on. That is the truth. Once people engage in severe conflict, like a dogfight, and things are just horrible, at some point they're going to want to disengage, and then you can help them. But right now, they still want to engage. So you cannot really do anything at this point, the way I see it, as far as really making much of an impact here. Because you will actually find yourself being dumbed down to the point where when they do want to disengage, you won't be able to help. Because again, the whole situation is based on leverage, not linear thought or action, a leverage. And the ego can manipulate that leverage to make every situation awkward. In the Bible it says that households will be divided against one another, friends will be divided against one another, people will be divided, meaning awkward situations will arise and people won't be able to straighten them out, and they say, what the heck's going on? I'm experiencing that now. Very awkward situations. I say, how in the world? That's crazy. How did that happen? And it get in the way of long-term friendships that you've been friends and have a good rapport, and something really awkward arises that is out of both of your hands, and it causes distrust and you know, poisons the atmosphere between you, etc. And you say, I can't straighten it out. I wish I could, but I feel helpless to straighten it out. That's the ego at work. That's the goddess of destructivity at work, creating enmity in the world. And the enmity is all the egoic leverage working. And it's beyond our control. It really is. And if you think you're smart enough to handle it, you're wrong. That's why the Holy Spirit tells us you cannot handle it, because it's all leverage at work, the egoic leverage at work. And you're helpless in the hands of that, because you haven't had the continuity problem solved. So you're helpless. You just simply, you know, stuff arises and it'll ruin relationships. And you say, that's crazy. How did that happen? You know, it's just this, the worst stuff at the worst time, and everything's orchestrated and rigged to cause you to hate somebody you used to love, you know, and you just say, I should be able to straighten it out. And the more you try to straighten it out, the worse it gets. You just can't. It's called enmity. The ego brings enmity between people here. So there's confusion, there's hatred, there's discord, there's frustration, all that stuff, dumbing down. And then we feel like, well, we got to solve the problem. You're not helping me. You're to blame. And so instead of realizing that we're trying to accomplish the impossible and be the authors of our own salvation, we end up blaming others, saying, you're the reason I can't do it. See? And here's the excuse. And the ego gives us these excuses, like a foolproof excuse, you know. It just orchestrates these excuses for us to hate. It's amazing. To distrust. To ruin the accord we have with one another, you know, like just a calm, trusting accord, you know, it ruins it, poisons the water, as it were. That's the ego at work. And so we think that we have good relationships in the world, but all of those can be ruined. All of them can be ruined. You can see, like in for instance, the churches, everybody think they have really great accord in a congregation of a church. And now you can see how churches are being split apart and factionalized over issues. And people are now hating one another, and so much turmoil within the churches, etc. And at some point they'll look and say, you know, I used to love you, we all love one another, and now we feel you're very wicked, very wrong. You know, you're on the wrong side of all these issues, and you're to blame. You're intolerant. You know, you're unforgiving. Blah blah blah. And the whole people are just simply lose that sense of accord with one another. You know, that gentle, peaceful accord where you can just sit with somebody and don't feel like you need to say anything. See, really, that's accord, isn't it? Where you don't feel like you need to say anything. that's true, true accord. And so that's going to be gone with the wind. Everybody is chewing on everybody else's ear and are all agitated over stuff. Agitated over issues. It's all by design. This is all the wind. It's not possible to linearly explain in words leverage and how it actually works. You have to see it. You can glimpse it and you can notice it. You can see it at work in the world. And just, your intelligence can say, wow, how did that happen? I could see that this and this and this, and oh my gosh, it brought this, like a perfect storm. You know, this perfect storm brought this about, and yet there's so many perfect storms. And then you realize everything is like a perfect storm. The ego manipulates everything to get us into a situation where we can, you know, have enmity, etc., and lose that accord, and lose that feeling like you don't need to do anything for me, I don't need to do anything for you, you don't need to do anything for me. We can't solve this problem together, we can't, apart or together, neither way we can solve it. So we accept this in one another, we turn to the Holy Spirit, and then we have this quiet accord. We're not conflicted with one another. Because we realize we're not the author of our own salvation, or we're not the author of someone else's. So what is there to get angry about towards each other over? Nothing, nothing. And then we have a sort of this peaceful accord of don't need to, what is there to discuss, etc., argue about? Nothing. But we can reinforce, remind one another, it's the Holy Spirit that solves the continuity problem. That's agape, that's real love. True love is to remind one another the Holy Spirit solves the continuity problem, not us. That's real love, that's agape. In this continuity issue, the situation we're in, is useless to talk about love. You know, it really is in reality. Love reality, forget it, we can't even imagine what it is. But we can talk about this agape, this reassurance of one another, of undemandingness, not demanding that we love one another, we get the love from someone. You know, I demand that you love me, and you demand that I love you, and we demand we must love one another. As long as the continuity issue is unresolved, we can't love one another. We cannot, it's impossible. But we can practice agape, which is to accept this fact. Like, says, I'm not expecting to get my happiness from you, and you're not expecting to get it from me. And let's not hate one another because we can't love one another, because we have this continuity problem and the ego has leverage over us. So let the Holy Spirit solve this problem for me, and then we will dwell in eternal oneness, the oneness of eternal love, which is beyond anything we can possibly imagine. So don't put these demands on one another. So when they say Jesus said that we don't love one another, well, what does that word mean? You see, what did he really say? You know, and so maybe it's be to reassure one another that it's okay that you can't solve my problems for me. That's okay. You know, that's the best we can do right now. It's okay. It's okay. So I say to all of you, it's okay. You cannot solve my problems. I'm okay with that. I'm okay. I can't solve your problems either. But we can together say, you know, this is okay. And thank you, Holy Spirit, for being here. It's like the Holy Spirit's like the new kid on the block, you know, like a brother, a new baby, a new brother, a new sister. Like, say, wow, I didn't know I had a sibling. You know, that's great. Welcome, Holy Spirit, to reality. I accept you. You know, we can do something like that. Say, Holy Spirit, previously you weren't there, but I'm so happy that God created you to share reality with us. And we're so blessed that you're here and grateful that you're here. And we welcome you to the family of reality. Because when we chose to try and be prime creator before then, there wasn't any Holy Spirit. So it's like a new birth, a new creation. It really is a new creation based on what we tried to do. And you know, instead of being a jealous child and say, no, I want to be the only child, I don't want any other children, then I say, oh, thank you, God, I'm so happy you gave us the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit will dwell with us in reality forever, eternally, and I'm very elated over that. And have that attitude of being happy that you have a new sibling and to share reality with. And the Holy Spirit doesn't interfere with our functioning, doesn't compete or anything, it just blesses, continues to bless all of reality with this wonderful, wonderful blessing. And so we can adjust our attitudes like this. We can, absolutely. So what is the next step? I don't know. I just hope more will watch these perceptual videos. I don't know, because I think that this is just like a kind of practice. It's like getting on the exercise bike. I gotta do that every day. I try to do it every day, but I don't. It's like, you know, it's easy to understand words, but when you see abstract perceptual stuff, it's like difficult. Like, what's being said here? What's the message? You know, well, there's no message. It's just that we're trying to get ready for something really exquisite. That's it. Something really exquisite that we don't need to do any maintenance on. No maintenance. We don't need to till the soil. We don't need to build fences. We don't need to use pesticides. We don't need to water. We don't need... It's just like a beautiful place that takes care of itself. It's self-maintaining. And that we can just enjoy. Just relax and feel this accord, you know. So how do we get ready? We get ready by those of us who are aware of this, who work to help out in some way of presenting exercises and ways to expand our expectations. Something that just it's so exquisitely, abstractly beautiful. And it's like this place just loves to put on a beautiful show for us and keep us in a saying very, very wonderful and beautiful. That's its pleasure. That's it loves to do that. And so we are very fortunate indeed to be where we're at. Very fortunate indeed. And not yet succumbing to the demand that we be the authors of our own salvation. And yet, there's no question that we're being pushed. They're trying to stuff us into that bag. And I know that's happening, no question about it. And so just acknowledge it in your own life to say, yeah, you know, I feel the heat is on. There's no question that the heat is on. I can feel it. And just say, okay, you know, let's keep the focus going, keep the efforts going. And that's what I'm doing, continuing. I'm okay, I'm fine. It's been difficult last several weeks, difficult, challenging, but you expect that, you expect it. I knew it was coming. And going great guns now and able to. So just in your own life, just continue to know that you are going to choose to let the Holy Spirit solve the resolution problem, the continuity problem. Let the Holy Spirit resolve it for you. And just say, okay, I'm okay. I'm going to be okay. So now let's prepare for avoiding the crush, you know, of being dumbed down. Let's avoid that. Let's avoid it. Definitely. Okay. That's it for this one. And we'll see what else pops up on this video, on this YouTube channel. You never know what could pop up here. I'm telling you. I don't have any idea what could happen. I don't know. But if something comes up, I'll throw it up there so for everyone to see. All right. God bless and take care. And we'll see what happens next.